Welcome, my viewers and my listeners of the program Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. I am your presenter, Pastor Florence Minor. I'm broadcasting live all the way from Minnesota, USA. Celebrate your moment with joy. Why? Not because things have gone the way you'd have wanted them to do. Not because your children have walked in the ways of the Lord you'd have been desired. Not that because your marriage is working like it's heaven on earth. Not because maybe you have gotten the best distinction in your school, in your exam. No, not because you have gotten the most handsome husband or the most beautiful wife in the world. No, we celebrate every moment with joy because we realize that it takes the grace of God for you to breathe in and to breathe out. And especially for this time of pandemic of COVID, we know that one of the symptoms is failure to breathe. Even when hospitals are full, they say that you don't go to see the doctor first, you call. But if you have shortness of breath, you are welcome to go there. That is why we should celebrate with joy every moment we breathe, because it is a big deal to be breathing, my brother, my sister. Yes, the title of my message today, thus far the Lord has been faithful. Today being the last day of the month of August, as most of you may know, or you will continue to know about me, every month, every starting of the month, I like to commit it to God in prayer. Not only in my personal prayer, but I like my viewers and my listeners to be encouraged to know that committing every day of the month to God does not take a whole day. No, we'll be doing that tomorrow. But because today is the last day of the month, it has taken the hand of God. And my words of reference will be from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 7, the entire chapter, but my key verse will be 12. Then I'm going to read it, then read back and forth. It says, verse 12. Ah, my goodness, this is what it says. Then Samuel took a stone and set it up between Pispah and Shen, and called its name Ebenezer, saying, thus far the Lord has helped us. I'll also go back to verse 5. It says, and Samuel said, gather all Israel at Mizpah, and I will pray to the Lord for you. So they gathered together at Mizpah, drew water, and poured it before the Lord. And they fasted that day and said there, we have sinned against the Lord. And Samuel judged the children of Israel at Mizpah. Verse 7. Now when the Philistines heard that the children of Israel had gathered together at Mizpah, the Lord of the Philistine went up against Israel. And when the children of Israel heard of it, they were afraid of the Philistine. So the children of Israel said to Samuel, do not cease to cry out to the Lord our God for us, that he may save us from the hand of the Philistine. Let us pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I want to thank you for the privilege of sharing your word. Use me as a vessel. Every listener and viewer under the sound of my voice who could be going through stuff and wondering what to do, may they know that once we look up to you, there is help that comes. I cover myself with the blood of Jesus from the hairs of my head to the toes of my feet. Oh God, against any attacks of the enemy that come to attack the voice and even the system we use, I want to thank you and to adore you. Take over. At the end of it, oh Lord, you shall receive all the glory and all the honor. I pray that I may decrease as you increase in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Here we see the Israelites had a challenge. You could be going through a challenge, my brother, my sister. But what you do during the time of challenge, it matters a lot. Do you know that your faith, you know who you are in the Lord during the time of challenges? How is your heart? Is your heart shaken? Your emotion, your humanity may be shaken. How about that inner man? Remember, God wants our heart to be preserved. When he allowed Satan to touch Job, everything Job had, he told him, do not touch his heart. Your heart is very, very important. Man and woman of God, you need to guard your heart. Whatever comes in your life, you need to learn to guard your heart. I am grateful to God that it is the last day of the month of August. I've seen it all. I've seen good things. I've seen hard, discouraging things. But because I committed every every day to God in prayer, I always remember, well, after all, it's in the hands of God. If I worry, what am I gonna do? Oh, yet they sing a song and say, Tidero tue murato tana tare agi. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a preference to carry. Freeing to God in prayer. Yes, Samuel, when he realized there was a challenge, he gathered. He told the children of Israel to gather at Mizpah. We have to have our Mizpah where we can gather and bring our concern and our troubles before the Lord. Gathering is very important. The issue of saying you can deal with it alone, you are making yourself awry. You cannot make it alone. If God said, let us make man in our own image, how about you, my brother? You need your brother, so you need your sister. We have seen that they were afraid. The Israelites were afraid of the Philistine. There is a Philistine in your life. There is a Philistine in your marriage. There is a Philistine as we serve. But we must learn to know that once we go before the Lord, He is the one who fights the battle for us. Several years back, our church, Grace Fellowship, we went through the series of the children of Israel going through this journey. In actual fact, even in our church compound, there is those stones. And if you Google, you can see the stones that were set there at Ebenezer. And in actual fact, Ebenezer means stone of help. You have had a stone of help for the month of August. And the way you have had the month of August with a stone of help from the Lord, God does not change. He is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Thus far, He has taken us. A singer sang and said, oh, Wadhani wakwa ni Ebenesa, ugo ni kuga hauginyete, tihoti wakwa kana inya wakwa, ni muadhi wakwa uginyivetie, korone inya wakwa mwene, dige kinya hauginyete, edi mwadhani ni Ebenesa, nikio diraiga newe hii, nyawakwa madena moka dogetigere barasioka dogetigere itamwadhani ni Ebenesa nadare hedia tagagotaithia. My brother, for you who could not hear that language, it says that when there is a problem, call the Lord who is Ebenesa. Oh, it says, then Samuel took a stone and set it up at Mizpah and Sen and called it Ebenezer. Why did he take that stone as a remembrance? It is always good when you do a Bible study, you pick at least three words that you can run with. You may not be able to summarize the entire chapter 7 of 1 Samuel at once, but you can just pick up three phrases. Like now, verse 7 it says, when the Philistine heard that the children had of Israel had gathered, when the enemy hear that you are gathering to encourage each other, he will come and shoot you with discouragement. Have you not come from a conference? You are so much encouraged. Just on Saturday, I was in a conference of our frontiers in our church. And the lead of the group that I joined for two sessions encouraged us. And I was feeling like, woman of God, this is me, this is me, this is me. And you get so encouraged, you get so inspired to know that you do not go through situations alone. And I remember one particular statement he made, that we all need help at some time. There are times we feel down even though we encourage people. I tell you, there are things I hear in life. I cry, I try to kneel down, I try to lie down flat. But what am I doing that time? I am looking to God. I'm looking for help. We need the help from the Lord. If your food needed the help of some spices to make it more sweeter, your spiritual life need help from other brethren to come with a summer, to come with a word of encouragement, to come with a testimony, so that we can make it and say, this far the Lord has taken us. You can go back to the first day of August, and I prayed through the month. Tomorrow I'll do the same. And I want to thank God that God had knew I needed to do that. I am off. I'm not working tonight. So that one will give me a chance to be able to do that. What a mighty God we serve. And even if I were, I can still set that time. I can be able to commit the month before God. What am I saying? Set a time. You have a missa where you can be able to gather in you. If you don't have many people, it is you, the Holy Spirit, oh God, the Father and the Son and the 24 elders and the heavenly host, they are with you. Oh, we need to live knowing that we need to be encouraged. Again, I want to encourage you to read the entire chapter. But let me read verse 13. So the Philistines were subdued, and they did not come anymore unto the territory of Israel. And the hand of the Lord was against the Philistine all the days of Samuel. Then the cities which the Philistines had taken from Israel were restored to Israel from Ekron to Gath, and Israel recovered its territory from the hands of the Philistines. Also, there was peace between Israel and the Amorites. I don't want to go far, but I tell you, there is a spirit of restoration. There is the restoration that comes when you go to seek help from the Lord. First and foremost, you restore your joy and the peace and your confidence in the Lord. Next thing, you restore your purpose is restored. What is your purpose, my brother, my sister? Have you been wandering away like a prodigal son from your purpose, from your call? No, there is an assignment that God has given you that nobody else will be able to do it except you. And until you agree to say, I am doing it, you can never live at peace. You can live blaming other people. That is why I'm not doing this, because of this and that. Mm-mm. Those are just like broken systems that cannot hold water. God is counting on you. Remember, this far God has brought us from day one of August. You started August. You did not know whether you'd be living. Many people started the month of August and they are not living anymore. It's not that you are better than them. There is nothing that you give God. It's just by the grace of God. Just even as I've sung a song saying, new to you are a guy. No, and if you want to check on my music, you can go online. I'll be attaching a link and you'll be blessed. And it goes like this. Nyotugiye wagai ukorwa moyo mothe nyotugiye wagai. May the Lord bless you. It takes the grace of God, what you do not deserve, the favor of God. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' name, I have given your word. Let it go forth. Let your Holy Spirit water it to bring forth fruit of encouragement in Jesus' name. You are there. You have never made that personal decision to follow the Lord. It is your chance. Do you want to say this prayer after me so that you can know, you can be able to go before the Lord, yourself alone, and say, God, I've come. You are my stone of help this hour. Do you want to say this prayer after me? Lord Jesus, I come before you. I repent of my sin. Forgive my timing all those years, oh God. Write my name in the book of life and give me a desire to grow spiritually in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. If you have prayed that prayer, you've been transformed. The old is gone and the new has come. Start walking in the newness of life. Look for a body of believers where you can be able to unite with them to be able to be encouraged. I love you. God loves you the most. Remember to subscribe to my channel of Celebrate Your Moment with Joy. Remember to check on my book, Fear Not, God is in Charge. And I thank you for the time you always take to listen to my message and to share with other people and to send a word of encouragement. Every moment counts. That's why you need to celebrate it with joy. Thank you.